Are we on?
Sweet Mary, I hope that wasn't on for your sake. I apologize. I had the strangest.
I like that music.
Salutation this weekend.
Yeah.
I didn't know what to make of it. It gave me pause. It was just so out of place for the circumstance. So let me tell you what happened.
All right.
I stop at your friendly Sip and Go. Mm-hmm. I got to run in and get a couple of things.
In there to get a beer? Were you in there to get a Coke?
Yeah, no, neither. It's funny you say that. I was in there to get a bottle of water and a package of almonds. Mm-hmm. If we need to know what the grocery list is. So that's what it is. So I go into the Sip and Go. I have a normal exchange with the attendant. He seemed like a very pleasant man. Mm-hmm. And we're done. And I say, I thank you. Have a good one. He said, you have a good one. Be careful. What? WTH?
Careful of what?
Be careful of what? We're not in a hurricane. There's nothing spooky. There's no bad weather. Did you think he meant be safe or?
Yes.
But be careful is like a strange.
Had a little bit of a warning.
Yes, it's like a warning. I don't need a warning.
It's a little warning.
Yeah.
Made you nervous for about 5 minutes.
It didn't really make me nervous, but it did.
Rest of the day, maybe I'm looking over my shoulder. Did you push me?
It was kind of Twilight Zone-ish. Like, you're right. When I pulled out into traffic, I gave it one extra look. But of all the things that people have said to me, and trust me, they've said a lot, I've never, after a short meeting, had anyone say, other than, you know what be careful is? Be careful only comes from your family. That's like the only person that tells, that's the only like group that tells.
I think mom tells children to be careful.
There you go, that's family.
Yeah, I think that's the
right?
I think that's the biggest user of the be careful line would be a mom.
But he said it very somberly almost. It did. It gave me a little bit of pause. I thought it was very strange, but then I just wrote it off to, maybe the guy was just, misspoke, thinking about something else.
All right, sports concepts and rationalizations coming your way. We call it the 10-minute drill. We kick it back and forth. At the end of the segment, we'll take caller number X and give out a prize pack that is incredible.
X is a letter,
Beef, do you know what the prize pack is?
Oh, boy, do I. Dan.
We're
hooking the Googans up with a selection from the 1010XL Valentine's Day gift guide.
Oh, this is good timing.
Your spot to get all the best gift ideas from 1010XL.com. Mm-hmm. Today's winner will get a $25 gift card to use at the Edwin Watts Golf Shop.
Fantastic.
And $50 to spend at Sherry's Berries.
Perfect. That'll be perfect. A couple of good gifts. One for you and one for your lady. So let's get this party started with this, Jeff Prosser. We talked a little bit about the Alliance of American Football. I like the pace of play. That was cool. Game's over in less than 3 hours.
2 hours.
I don't need kickoffs. I noticed that. That doesn't bother me, not having a kickoff. So overall, I guess if you want to grade it or talk about it, tell us what you thought of the AAF. But more importantly, look, it leaves CBS, it goes to CBS Sports Network, other leagues, fledgling leagues have always had a good opening debut. Does it have staying power?
Well, with me, because I know it's CBS Sports Network, but your point is probably the most valid of the ones that don't get spoken too much, and that is
right.
Saturday night prime time on CBS National Network is a big difference from Saturday afternoon or Sunday afternoon 4 o'clock on the CBS Sports Network.
Yes.
I mean, those are two different animals.
Do you know where CBS Sports Network is on your dial?
Come on, who are you talking? 393. I mean, who are you talking?
That's a tough find.
Yeah, that's an easy find for me, but for most people it won't be.
Yeah.
I tell you what, this is not normally considered a huge compliment.
Okay.
But I think in the case of the AAF, they should take this as a huge compliment compared to other football leagues in the past. Mm. I found it to be watchable.
Okay.
I didn't need it tricked up. I was just familiar enough with the players to understand. I joined watching Spurrier.
They certainly tried to hire star power for coaches. Spurrier was ambling around, by the way. He had back surgery just like
recently. Is that what it is?
Yes.
I was wondering why he couldn't walk. I was worried about it.
No, he's okay.
All right, good. I was afraid he'd need a new hip or something.
No. He's had the back surgery, and he's getting back a little bit.
I think what really jumped out to me, too, is that it's pretty clear, and I mentioned this last segment, that, the NFL has gone real sneakily, and they've set up a minor league, without having to call it a minor league. And with all the NFL, former NFL personnel running it, that's what it's going to be. I would say this, Dan, I bet you 80 guys playing in this league spend time in the NFL this year.
Well, our drill poll question of the day, brought to you by Lockett Law for DUI Criminal Defense. How do you feel about the new AAF football league? I'm all in. Go Apollo's 28%, better than I thought, 43%. So that's over 70% digging it. If there's nothing else, 21%. Huh? What's that? 8%. So more than 500 votes are in. And if you need Lockett Law for DUI, criminal defense, 858-9818.
I'm sorry, I've just gotten a text from somebody who's been to that same Sip and Go, and he says that to everyone.
Okay.
All right, good. It wasn't something about me that indicated peril was, that peril was on the way. But yeah, overall, I think watchable is a good enough compliment, and for me, I think they also do a great job in the broadcast. I do. I think it's very important with a league like that, every play, tell me where this guy went to school. It legitimizes you.
Yeah.
There's so-and-so at the tackle. He played collegiately at Auburn. Or there's so-and-so. He's from Southern Miss. I like that because it re-engages. And so we'll see. I don't – you're right about one thing. The debut is always the best ratings, and they didn't have monster ratings. Not like they got a 10.
Right.
So, you know, we'll see. Florida and Florida State's basketball programs continue to do what they've done since opening night. Go in different directions. The Noles pounded Florida in the season opener.
Yeah.
And except for a little blip a few weeks ago, it's been, you know, right on cue as a ranked team. Florida, meanwhile, young, battered, and done. That was it. Now they're done. And can they be a 500 team and make the NIT and get some much-needed practice time?
I think now that they've gone through this little gauntlet they had with Auburn and Tennessee and Kentucky and Ole Miss and –
the problem is LSU, they got twice, they're better than two of those teams.
That's true, but they have Vandy and Georgia. They got some winnable games here. Now, well, how's their psyche? That's the biggest question after getting pounded, being a young team. You got to keep playing the young guys. You got to keep going back out there. Listen, nobody feels sorry for you. Nobody cares.
Yeah.
Everybody loves to beat Florida still because of its tradition in basketball, recent tradition of winning some championships, so it's always a big win. It's a, you know, Tennessee enjoyed stomping on the Gators, and rightfully so. I have no problem with it. So they've got some work to do. And FSU's rebounded nicely, 1-4 in the ACC to start, and
won five or six in a row. Now
they look again like a team that could make a deep run into the
tournament. Anonymous, huh? They're really anonymous. I mean, they really are. I mean, look, don't get me wrong. I've watched five or six FSU games, Dan, and I'm a big college basketball fan. I'm not sure I can name more than about six guys.
Jay Billis comes to mind when I think of FSU, long and athletic. Long and athletic.
Well, that's fair.
What they are.
Yeah.
Every guy that comes off the bench
is
6'8", long and athletic.
Yeah.
And good for Leonard Hamilton. Again, a nice resurgence into his 70s now as a coach. And he's had a couple good runs, a couple good tournament appearances for FSU. They're doing some things recruiting-wise. So, you know, that Cabangali kid is a really good basketball player.
Yeah.
So, you know, they're a good program in the ACC, the powerhouse ACC. So, wonderful wins. What's going on? I did a mock draft again. I love those little mock draft things.
Yeah, we did one last week.
Yeah, well, I did one yesterday.
With my personnel.
Yeah, I did one yesterday, and I really liked it. I went under the assumption I got Foles. And this time I got Jonah Williams at
seven.
At seven.
He's offensive tackle for Bama.
I got Irv Smith, a tight end. I got Dalton Risner from Kansas State, who started 49 games and played some at center and some at tackle. So he's very, you know, flexible in terms of what he can do. 6'5", 309. So I got him. Then I got Lil Jordan, of course, because he's my guy who had a big year. And I got two running backs in Holyfield, Rodney Anderson. So I redid the running back room. And I even went ahead and snagged Greg Dortch from Wake Forest, who had 80-some catches and 9 touchdowns in the 7th round. But two offensive...
You are going to wear that mock draft out, buddy.
I know. Two offensive linemen, Jeff Prosser, in the draft. Would that upset you as a fan? And not drafting a quarterback, how would you think? I don't think, again, I'm going to say this now, and this got low numbers on our poll question that we've done in the past, but I do believe if I sign Nick Foles, Jeff Prosser, I'm not drafting a quarterback in the 3rd round. I'm just not.
I'm not either. I've been saying that all along.
Yeah.
It certainly seems like those inside and around the league believe that Tom Coughlin is going to go after Nick Foles, that the Giants are going to be the team that gets Nick Foles. And I'm okay with that. I'm not sure it's the
But if you get him, you've got to put guys around
him.
Right. So
okay,
you've got to fix the offensive line.
Yeah.
You've got to get him a Zach Ertz,
I need two receivers, a tight end.
Yeah.
I need a lot.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, you need a lot. There's no doubt.
Yeah. So,
there's no doubt.
Yeah, and if I sign my quarterback for pretty high dollars, by the way.
Right.
Yeah, I'm not gonna take a quarterback in round one. That doesn't make much sense to me.
Okay.
So, all right. Well, that's the 10-minute drill.
Oh?
Yeah.
All right.
So we got a lot coming. We're going to do a lot of golf today. We're broadcasting live from TPC Sawgrass. It's they got the charity shootout and media day here. We're going to get to visit with Webb Simpson, who dominated so much last year here that it's almost not very memorable.
Yeah.
If you remember, Webb built like a huge seven-shot lead.
He had a 63 on either – was it Saturday 63 he had? Or Friday?
I don't know. It was either Friday or Saturday. I know that it was a very – non-dramatic final round. I mean, Webb said I remember him putting lights out. And just
nothing better than that, by the way.
No one could make a run at it. But anyway, and he's got a local caddy and friend of the program. We've known Paul Tesori for years.
Yep.
The two of them will join us at 8:30. Billy Horschel, who's played pretty good golf here in 2019, by the way. He's part of the charity shootout today.
All right.
He's going to stop by and visit with us at 8:15.
All right.
Breakfast with Pacelli.
Oh.
Before Tony shanks a couple into the pond out there at number 17.
Boy.
He'll stop by and visit with us at 9. So we're going to have a lot of fun with some guests here as we move along on a Monday morning quarterback divorce.
We'll take caller number 4 at 641-1010. Caller number 4 for the Valentine's Day prize pack, Beef.
That's right. $50 to spend at Sherry's Berries and $25 from Edwin Watts Golf, part of the Valentine's Day gift guide. Head to 1010XL.com. Click the Valentine's Day gift guide and get all those great Valentine's Day gift ideas. Just 3 days away, guys. Hurry up.